Yeah, thanks. So thanks everyone for joining this session during the weekend. So I will try to provide as much as information so that you will be able to utilize the time. So I wanted to make it as interactive. So if you are having any questions or any query, you can feel free to me. So today I am going to provide a session on the topic called email preferences. So in this session, the agenda is I will be providing the introduction, what is the purpose of the preference center, and what are the things present in the preference center and the building blocks of the preference center. Then I will be showing you the demo, and then after that Q&A session. So you can feel free to stop me if you are having any queries or anything during a session. So intro, and you already provided the intro about me. So I will be just straightforward moving to the session. So with the help of this session, you will be able to understand how you can utilize the preferences. So people sometimes called as a consent also to this. So nowadays, the consent is very important because you cannot send irrelevant mails to the end user if you are subscribing to your website. So they can raise a privacy issue, or as well as they can raise a complaints against your brand identity itself if you are keep sending the email which are they are not intended to send. So first we will go to the problem statement, why the need is required for the preference center or a consent management system. Because whenever you are trying to build any web properties, so main purpose of your organization or your product is to interact the user into your website. So best example is the e-commerce website. So there you will be going and looking for some type of product, right, which are you are in interested, right, and you want to buy it, but sometimes you will not buy it, then they will prompt you to register it, right? So with that way you will start engaging yourself with the particular web properties. So if those things and those web properties will keep sending you a mails if you are not interested to go back again to the websites. Nowadays there are many web properties are there and people are going only one time, right, to there, and after that they will not go, or that data or a product which are not useful for you, but you will be keep getting the lots of emails like it during a holiday sessions, right? If any sales will start like Black Friday or the Cyber Monday sales, right? So you will be interacting with the user and you will be informing before the sales, right, this is going to start. And before that you are going into that user journey, maybe some time back you have interacted with that website, right, from anywhere through any of the channels into the over the web, right? But now you are not interested into that, but keep getting those type of emails, but you are not finding a provision, or the web property is not taking this as a serious things, so that they can provide you the option to unsubscribe or opt out from that. And in the European territory, these are the comes under the data privacy laws, like GDPR, and the geographic locks are there. They are also telling that if you are creating any brand identity over the internet, so if you are taking user PII data, so first of all that PII data do not needs to be disclosed, as well as user should have the flexibility to opt out any given point of time, and going forward they will be not able to receive any of the communication, either it will be SMS, emails, or phone calls. So in a generic, you can unsubscribe the user immediately from the email, right? But if you are enrolling a particular person into the SMS, so industry standard is that if user is sending a stop message to your SMS gateway, so within a 2 minutes your system should react and it should not send any message, right? So if you are sending any message after 2 minutes, right, so they can take a serious action against you also, into not in India but in US and the Europe. So these things are very important. So any questions why we need to use the Sitecore Preference Center? Any queries? I think silence I will take as a no.
Yeah, looks like that's good. Go on.
So, okay. So what is Sitecore Preference Center can do for you? So, so if you are building any of the web application or a web property into the Sitecore, so most of the people earlier used to use the Sitecore as a just a plain content management system. But nowadays people are utilizing full-fledged Sitecore as a complete experience platform, you can say that, or a true experience platform. With the help of that, they are creating the user journey, right? Customer experience journey they are creating. So they are tracking each and every footprint of the user, where user are interacting to the website, and they are taking a proactive action, and they are prompting some sort of content as well as some sort of promotions to you, so that they can interact to any type of marketing automation plan or any type of offer, so that you will again come back to their website. So with this Sitecore Preference Center, what you can do that, let's say an example that you are having an organization, right? They are selling many products, right? And within that organization, you are also having the sales and marketing team, you are having the HR team, right? And suppose you can also have a different department related to a different categories like electronics, electrical, right? And each individual having their own digital marketing team. So in that case, what they can do that once you are going to their website and into a specific category, they can present you a subscription. So to make a user identifiable, right? So first thing the application needs to do that, they need to identify your identity, right? Otherwise they will be not able to interact with you in near future. So for that, most of the website is giving a very good message that if you will enroll to our website, we will give you a this much discount, or you will get these many resources. So with the help of that, they will make you as a identifiable user, right? So from that, your user journey will start. You will start interacting with the website. So in those cases, it's very critical or important from a brand point of view that you will be able to identify each and individual user with respect to where they are interacting, right? So Sitecore Preference Center is a out of the box offering, right, which is coming with the EXM, and with the help of that you can take care of all those things. And this product, you can say that the offering of the EXM is present from Sitecore 9.1 or onwards, and for that you should have the experience license. You cannot use the experience management to utilize this. So all of the things where you are interacting with the user at a later phase, right? So for all those, you will require the experience platform license, because the experience management will be a in-memory personalization. So you cannot work on the historical data of the user, because in experience management, you are not storing the user content into your system like analytics database. And with the help of Sitecore Preference Center, you can use the user segmentation also. So I, like I said, that there will be a different departments, right? Or a categories like electricals, electronics, or mobile. So if user are enrolling to that particular category, so you can create a specific segmentation list, and later phase you can enroll user into a marketing automation plan, and you can send a offer as per user interaction, how user is proceeding. So with the help of a preference center, what it will do, it will provide you the unique URL which is sent to each and every user, so that they can interact with their preference center and they can opt in, opt out. So in the market, there are many products are there which are providing these services as a extra, like a one test is there, possible now is there. They are also providing a SaaS based offering to manage all these things as a enterprise level. So with the Sitecore Preference Center, there are the things like, it is not providing you the opportunity to create a hierarchical data. For example, if you want to maintain a preferences, suppose you are having a 10 departments or a and for 10 departments you need to send a opt-out email which will show you a like a particular department like mobile, and all the email, SMS and those options will be presented to you. So those things are not present in the Sitecore Preference Center. It is providing you to take care of the only the email preferences, but you can tweak it in such a way that for each marketing category you can treat it as a one sort of option that you need to manage manually. But if you will go to any other third party offering, they are providing you a, you can create a n number of channels in which you are enrolling to the user, and they will share the details or store the details specific to each channel. So the in a overall at a high level, if you will see how the Sitecore Preference Center will work, you are having the content management system, and you will be creating a multi-site environment like a site one and site two, and number of sites you can create because Sitecore supports multi-tenant, multi-site concepts. And for each website, you can create their own preference center, or you can utilize the generic preference center and you can enroll user into that. And from there, it will be publicly available, or you can say that you will be having a content tree, and you can publish the site so that user can interact with individual sites, and content author anyhow can interact with your website to change the content. So in that case, Sitecore Preference Center is providing you a centralized way to manage all the your web properties which you are having within your Sitecore CMS instance. And it is also utilizing the analytics database, because you need to take care of your, if user is opt out, so there will be no email sent to the user. So now I will be explaining what are the things which we will be utilizing it, or how we can start with the Sitecore Preference Center. So into your website, right, to make it user interactive, you need to subscribe user that, because you should know to whom you need to send an email, right? So there are the way, like if you are having a any Salesforce CRM system, from there you can import the contacts into your contact list. Or if you are having any legacy system, right, and you are moving to the Sitecore, then you can enroll all those users via a Sitecore contact list. And suppose if you are having a CRM system, right, or you are having a organization, they are having an online presence also as an offline presence also, and you are into the n number of business, like you are into the hospitality industry and you are running a grocery stores also, and you are running a you can say that it's some sort of e-commerce properties also. So in those cases, in an enterprise organization, there are the data lake concept is there. So data lake is nothing but you are having a 360 degree view of the user, and from all the channels you are pushing the data into a data lake, and there you are making or processing or orchestrating your data, and you are identifying a unique user. So you can become from an offline channel, you can come from the online channel. So there will be a single identity will be present, like, and from there that data also you can ingest. So there you need to create a custom facet. For example, if you are going to the offline grocery store and you are more interested into the soft drinks, or a, you can say that the diet oriented person, right? So like that, you can create a different contact facets into your Sitecore contact, right? And if you are coming to their online channel, if you're interested in the mobile or a, any other gaming things, right? So like that, you can add a custom attribute to user profile, and that you can ingest into the Sitecore. And from there, you can customize your complete user persona there. So at enterprise level, people are utilizing Sitecore in such a way that they can create a single identity and they can personalize your experience. So with that, you can import all your contacts into the Sitecore contact list. And as I said that you can create a multi-site. So in that, suppose you are having a corporate website, inside that you can have HR department, different like a finance department, right? So each can have their own brand identity and their own email preferences. And there is a very important thing. If you are utilizing the Sitecore Experience Manager, there is a one item called a Sitecore Manager root, right? So whatever the email messages or a EXM campaign you are storing into your Sitecore or creating it, that will be residing or going into a particular manager root, and that manager root will be keep tracking of all the user preferences. So your EXM will be, email campaign will be tagged with to a particular, you can say that manager root. And if you will go to your Sitecore system and you will open the Sitecore Experience Manager, so you will find a list of the manager root which you are having, and inside that you will find how many numbers of email campaign you have created. So this is the main item which will take care of what will be the base URL. If user are clicking or interacting with your email, where user needs to implement, what will be the preview URL, right? And what will be the unsubscribe list. So all those things, you can say that this is the parent of all the emails, and it will contain all the opt-in, opt-out related detail and where user needs to add, means land to the website. So once you will send a email, right? So EXM will automatically having a pixels into your email. So if you are opening or anything, there will be a AJAX call will be made from that particular email, and it will be sending data to a your Sitecore, similar to you have a Facebook pixel and Google pixel. Sitecore is also having a Sitecore pixel, which is a hidden, like a 1px type of image. You will be not able to see that, but it is embedded into your email, and with the help of that, your data is being tracked. And with the help of a EXM, if you are opening any email, right? So it is providing the out of the box functionality to view the email into the browser. But if you are using any SMTP directly, so you need to create a page specifically to see your email into the any website or any web property. But with the EXM, it's out of the box thing. So this is the Sitecore Preference Center. So here you are seeing that you are having a different radio boxes, right? That is nothing but a marketing categories under which you are enrolling your user. Suppose if you are having a corporate site, right, and you want to send a emailer to the user, right? So you need to take a consent to the user, from the user, that in which type of things you are interested. So if user will select any of the category, then you can move user to a particular marketing category within a particular segmentation list. So going forward, if you need to send any emailer, you just need to pick up that particular segmentation list and you can send an email. You do not need to do any manual work there. So with the help of a Sitecore Preference Center, right? So in this screen, I am displaying two things. One is the left hand side screen and the right hand side. So you are seeing the 1, 2, 3 numbers, right? So these are the things which you can customize. So you can add your own logo and you can change the text, categories, button color, and the text. All these things you can customize with the Sitecore Preference Center. And the segmentation list is that it is based on a particular rule. So suppose there are two things. One is the contact list, one is the segmentation list. So contact list is a plain list where you are importing or directly adding the user into a list via programmatically, or you can say that you are importing the data. So that is a master list. If you are moving the user from one segmentation list to another segmentation list, user are not going to delete from your contact list. It will be present as is. So it's just a logical entity which is run on the basis of your custom segmentation rules, because Sitecore will store the context into the Sitecore Analytics database, right? And you are having the reporting database also. So what happened there? Sitecore Analytics database is the main database which will aggregate the data to the reporting database with respect to your interaction. and those interaction will be synced to your Sitecore analytics index in the Solr. So whenever you are doing these type of movements, so you will see the immediate changes, because those data is being updated at a real time into your context, and then indexing is happening, and you are able to see the data movement very fast. And also, if you are searching any context into the Sitecore, those data will be directly coming from the analytics database. But prior to Sitecore 9.x, those details were coming from the Sitecore MongoDB directly. Any questions till this slide?
Hey Amit, Sumit this side. Yes. I want to know, how do we access the Sitecore Preference Center?
So I am going to show you the demo after completing this.
Okay.
So I will be doing that.
Okay.
So you need to create a particular segmentation rules. So there, what you need to do that, you need, because you are creating your marketing categories, if user is clicking or checkout or opt-in or opt-out, any type of marketing category, so you can move user to that particular segmentation list on the basis of these custom segmentation rules. User will be automatically land into your particular segmentation category. So once user will change their preferences, then user will be automatically adding into a particular segmentation list. Once you will perform any action on the preference center screen, which you can access from a direct email, and you will see that user will be automatically changing. Suppose if I am having a newsletter list and a product update, if user is enrolling to both, then user entry will be go into a to list. And once you will go to the experience profile there also, because if you are subscribing via a registration form, so what will happen that you need to create a Sitecore contact, and you need to identify that contact, particular contact or the user who are registering. Then automatically your details will start coming into your website, or sorry, Sitecore experience profile. And with the help of a Sitecore experience profile, you can track the user journey, how many campaigns have been sent, right? And user clicks where into your website, which type of goals user have interacted. So all these things you can interact or you find from the this activity journey of the user from the experience profile. It the below screen, in this screen you are seeing the contact details, right? So whatever the custom facets you are creating, so all this you can add it here. And I was giving the example of a CRM system, right? So suppose you can create a custom facet and you can map into this. And there is a Salesforce CRM integration is also present in Sitecore. It's out of the box connector. So from there also you can sync the data into the Sitecore, and all the SFMC facets or attribute will be automatically mapped into the Sitecore. You do not need to do anything. So this is the activity of the user, which particular campaign user have enrolled, and what are the events user have performed. This is the email campaign where you are going to create a particular email campaign. Suppose if you are enrolling user to a website, so people generally what they will do, they will rely on the SendGrid, they will rely on the plain vanilla SMTP to send an email, and they will create an email template in the form of an item, right, into the Sitecore, and they will merge the tag and they will send. So it's better if you are having the experience platform license, you can utilize the Sitecore email campaign so that you do not need to pay any extra money or the charges to SendGrid to take an activity or a track to activity of the user. So you can utilize this, and you can programmatically trigger this email, and you can change the token, whatever you are creating here, with from the code itself, and you can trigger it. So with the help of a EXM email campaign analytics, you can track the activity to whom the email have been sent. So whenever email EXM email or a campaign will be sent, there is a EXM log is there, so you can see that to whom the email have been sent or is there any error. So you will be able to find all the details into the EXM log. If you face any issue, you can track it from there. So this is just the picture of that, how your email campaign is performing. So digital marketing team can track it, how many users are interacting with the help of this. So it is giving you the complete analytics, who have opened it and who have clicked on your particular email campaign. So coming to that, the building blocks, like I already explained, like those are the manage route, marketing category, site core analytics, contact list, defense center branding, SMTP. These are the building blocks. With the help of that, you can create a full-fledged site core preference center and you can use that. So any question till this slide? So I have just trying to explain how user will interact to your website. So suppose you are seeing here is that you are having a website, right? And here what I am trying to explain that if you are going to start a particular preference center creation, so first you need to identify that the site core manager routes are present or not, right? If it is not present, you need to create it. Then you will go and identify that the email campaigns you are going to utilize is, or those are the existing ones, or you need to create new one. Then after that, there are the other step like creation of the marketing categories, landing pages. So all these things you have to identify. So I try to explain all these steps into that. So why I have created this flow, that so that once you will start creating anything, right, in not related to Sitecore Preference Center or any of the user story you are going to work, so you need to do the complete impact analysis to identify that what are the impact you are going to do into the system, so that it will help you to guess how much efforts you require to complete this activity. So with the help of that, you will be able to identify that how many efforts is required from your side, what is manual and what is automation things, so you can explain those things. So this diagram is clearly visible, or I need to zoom in more on this?
It's a little small. If you can zoom in, that'd be good. Yeah, cool, thank you.
So as I said that, if yes.
Yeah, Amit, I have a question. When you yes. say is created, are we talking about the Sitecore site, or are we talking
yes,
about the?
Yes, suppose I am talking about the Sitecore site. Means is site created, means site is currently present or not, or you need to implement into a new site. So I started a journey from there itself, right? So then it will be coming to the manager route, right? Because manager route, you will be having a marketing categories. You need to give a references of that. So if that marketing category is not present, you are going to create a marketing categories. There is a global opt-out concept is there. So that is very good concept in a Sitecore that is coming out of the box. So what is the meaning of that? Suppose you are having n number of website into your application, or your single Sitecore instance, right? And there multiple teams are working from a different departments, and they are running their own campaign. So while designing a particular email manager route, you can decide that which particular global opt-out list we have to utilize that. So what will happen that, suppose you are having a finance department, they are running their own campaign, and they are having their own preference center itself. And you are having the marketing team, they are running their own email campaign, and they are having their own, you can say that, the marketing category. But at a organization level, you should have a single global opt-out list, so that you will not send any email to the user if they have globally opt-out from your organization. So in that case, it's better to utilize the global opt-out. If you will opt out from there, then while sending a email, suppose you have created an automated plan itself, when EXM will run, EXM will be campaign will be checked that what is the this global opt-out list are attached to this particular Sitecore manager route, and it will automatically filter those users and it will not send an email to those users. So in that case, this is very important to identify that which particular global opt-out list you are going to create. So after that, what you will do that if it is not present, you will create an SMTP. You can utilize that because there is no need to use the SendGrid. So you can utilize this also. And after that, you can set up the preference center. You can assign the pages and you can assign the marketing category, or you need to do any cosmetic changes, you can do that. And then you can create your own segmentation list on the basis of a marketing category, which you have already created it. And then is email campaign present for a manager route, right? If it is email campaign is not present, you are going to create a email campaign. It can be a automated email campaign which will be run from your marketing automation, or if you are running manually, you can create a regular email campaign also. And also you can assign the participant details into that, right? And after that you can execute that particular email campaign, and going forward user will be start interacting with your preference center or your website, and from there you can start modifying, or you can say that start monitoring the user journey from there itself.
Another question, yes. How is site linked with the email manager route? Because EXM,
yes,
manager, like a separate node or a separate item, usually it's not site. So why is site created?
Well, wait a minute. So let me know once you're able to see my screen.
Yeah, I'm able to see.
See, so it's up to you how you are managing your content tree. So by default, when you will create, there is a default email manager route is present, right?
Yep.
So why I'm telling that to create a site specific email route, because you can manage. So it's up to you where you can place it. It's nothing just but a item. So while you are creating your content tree, you are creating the logical relationship between your items, right?
Yeah.
But it's up to you. You can create it as a globally also. But if you are creating a best content architecture or information architecture, you need to create a logical connectivity between your site and the items you are having. So that's why I told that create a site specific email manager route, so that you are easily able to manage the campaign within a website itself. So this is completely directly coupled with user access also, because if you are having a 10 departments, right? So each department person should not have a access to other department email campaign, right? So in that manner you can segregate these email campaigns with each department also.
I understand the logical architecture, and to make it relatable, we should have one folder or one node. I understand that part, but ideally or in actual practice, email corporate is not linked with the home or anything to do with the corporate site, right? It's just that for logical understanding and having a clean architecture in the content tree, we are keeping it.
Yes.
Okay, then it's fine.
So how the site will be interacting with your this? So there is a base URL is there in any email manager route, site manager route. So with that, it will land to a your website and it will give the URL of that, right? Suppose if you are adding any URL into your email campaign, so this URL will be pre-appended into that, and then user will land into your particular website. So you can give your main site URL itself, how you are going to manage your campaign management system within a sitecore, it's totally depend upon that.
Okay.
Right. So with this, you are making a connectivity with the sitecore manager route. And here you can define already, you can say that there is a page if you are already unsubscribed, so it will give you that. If you again click on that, it will give you a link where you need to land to the user. These are the final confirmation page, and this is the global opt-out list which you can create, and the reply to email. And if you need to track the user have a bounce mail or something, you need to set up your this OP3 email also. With the help of that, you will receive an input from the third party SMTP to whom you are sending an email that it is a bounce or not. And this is the name of your message header which you are going to see into that. And this is the heading or the branding of that Defense Center. And here you are defining a marketing categories. So these marketing categories are present within a, you can say that the system marketing control panel taxonomies, and inside that you are having the marketing categories, and that you are defining as a source and user. You can select a number of marketing categories here, and these are the you can say that the Preference Center title, what would be the title of your Preference Center page, and those are the token which is being replaced with these. So these are the token based, whatever the text you are going to display, all these things will be automatically changing with the help of a token. And you can change the HTML there. If you need to ingest any HTML, you can do all these changes here. And Preference Center and subscribe from all. So this is the message you can give. And these are the JavaScript which is being embedded into your you can say that a Preference Center. So coming to the Preference Center, how it will be initiated. So generally, when you are not using the sitecore forms, or you are not using the sitecore Preference Center, so what people are doing it, they are creating a custom functions, they are sending a email, right? And they are creating to handle a preferences. What they are doing it, they are creating the custom facets into the sitecore contact, and with the help of that, they are creating the segmentation list to identify that user have enrolled into which particular website, or user have enrolled into a which particular category. So that type of practice, people are doing it. To avoid that, what we can do that, we can utilize the Preference Center. So what I have done that, I have created this custom contact list. So I have already enrolled a user into that. And what I will do that, I will use one of the email campaign. So once you will create the email campaign, it will be storing with the help of within a message, and with the help of that, these are the month, and you will be able to find that what particular email campaign you have created. It will be also present into the content. So I am going to utilize this particular thing. So it's already sent. I will save it. Finish it. So this is my email campaign. So I was explaining about this is the marketing sitecore manager rule. So within that, each and every email campaign you are creating is grouped together. So what I will do, I will go to the full email campaign. So I have having in my list here. I will select this. And there is a global opt-out list is there. You can select a list from there. So whenever you will create any of the email campaign, right, so automatically you will find this particular unsubscribe links also. So what I did there, I have provided the token into that, and these are the links for the preference center automatically. And you will click on that, then you will be land into a preference center. So let me. Delivery. So from there, I will just send a email campaign. So email campaign have been sent. So I am having some dummy email. So email needs to come here. So you saw that its email have been received for this user. So if I will click on that, what happened? So this is nothing to do with this particular thing. This is the mailinator is not redirecting to that particular email address. Let me see what others we are having. Oh, what happened here? So this is the email you have seen that I have added all the categories related to that, and this user is Prashant, right? So if I will go to my sitecore to a particular segmentation list, we go from here. So I'm having these many categories. So currently it's not enrolled to anything. Suppose if I will enroll that user into a finance category and I will update my subscription. So currently it's a 4, then it become a 5, right? So automatically its user have been enrolled into this particular marketing category. So now again, I will go there. And I will again click on the email preferences, right? Now I will enroll to the corporate offers and this, and I will uncheck this. So now this needs to become a 4. So this user have been removed from there, right? So what is the benefit of this thing is that, so suppose if you are running a campaign like this and while you are enrolling user to your website, so you can give a preferences and you can take the consent of the user that to these many categories you would you like to receive the messages or the not, right? And same way, if suppose I will also umbrella corporate offers. This user is also present here. So I was telling you that I can utilize the single segmentation list and I can utilize that into a for a different number of you can say that the marketing campaign itself. So here what I need to mention that when the contact gets subscribed to, subscribe is nothing but you are opting into a particular marketing category and your preference is to receive a this specific marketing category email and you can mention the manager route. So you are seeing that the manager route is the parent for your all these things, right? So with that way you can structure your content tree itself. So you can enroll from a number of manager route or the number of categories into a single segmentation list also. So that is a one way of enrolling user. So suppose if I am utilizing the Sitecore forms to create that, so what I can do that so I can create a Sitecore form also and I will go to So with the help of a marketing automation plan also, we can send a user any email also. So with the help of that, this marketing, Sitecore Preference Center, what we do not need to do that, suppose in going forward, right? You have enrolled user into a different new subscription or a offers into that. And these segmentation list can be utilized automatically while sending an email. So once we went to a particular email campaign earlier. Where is that? So I have utilized this. So once I will go into my campaign, right? So I will be able to identify that. So this is today's date, right? Whoever opened it, right? So it will give you a complete detail. Bounce rate, the POP3 settings we have mentioned, right? So with the help of that, it will give you whoever unsubscribe it, those details also you can take it from there. Anyone can doing the spam complaints that also will come here. And you can set the engagement value with the help of a marketing automation plan also to see this. And whoever land into your website from your campaign, you can also do that. But if you are again running any of the campaign and you need to utilize that, so you can select a recipient list from the here itself and you can run the campaign. So you do not need to explicitly create your segmentation list to do that. So let's see the mail came or not. So from there also we have received one email. And here also I am utilizing the same like an article. I will enroll this user. So it's got increased. So now what I will do, that I will go to my preferences and I will again open and I will unsubscribe from all, right? Now if I will go here, so this needs to be removed. That user have been removed because that user was the anonymous user. So if I will perform from the other, this also will remove. Why it is not working? Page, where it is here. So I can uncheck and I can again enroll to again. So it's not like that. If I will unsubscribe once time, I cannot go to my email and I cannot again subscribe to your emails. There is a one more option like unsubscribe, right? So it's a final confirmation page which you have given to the user. So with this you are subscribing directly from all the preferences. So with the help of that, what we can do, that we can create a different segmentation list and we can enroll, and we do not need to do any manual intervention to manage the user, like, and also we do not need to do any extra precaution while sending an email. If we are aware about that, whatever particular opt-out list and we have created a proper segregation between the departments, then we can easily do or send an email campaign to the list. So the only thing is that there is a not much configuration, or you can say that the customization you can do with the this reference center. Why? Because you suppose this is the main category, and inside that if you need to go do a child category where you need to have a each individual department, those type of parent child relationship is not supported by this particular Sitecore preference center. And currently in the industry there is only some leaders are there who are providing that of functionality. So those functionality will come into the picture if you are running a separate brand identity within your organization, right? And each having a different type of marketing department, and each is having their own preferences. So if they want to see for a particular user, if they have enrolled to an number of website, into an number of website, if they wanted to see all the preferences in a one view, that type of thing is not supported in Sitecore. Any question? Am I audible?
Yes, Amit, you're audible. I guess no questions at this time.
Yes, so this is the simplest way to implement the preference centers and we can manage it. So that's all I wanted to cover in this so that we can start utilizing this without creating any custom implementation in our Sitecore implementation.
All right. If anyone has any questions, now is a good time. Great. I think we're good for now. If anyone does have any questions, feel free to reach out to Amit. All his contact information is up on the screen. Thank you so much, Amit, for taking the time for presenting for us.
Right? Yeah, thanks. As usual, Bangalore and Annie for the coordination.
Thank you. And thank you, everyone, for joining. We'll be uploading the video shortly on our YouTube channel. So thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everyone, for joining. Have a great day.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you.